Hello and welcome everyone to the 10th episode of Inside AMG, where we have arrived at the letter J. And for us, J is gonna stand for journey. What's the perfect car for epic journeys? This car right behind me, the Mercedes-AMG G63, and that's gonna be the star of today's video. However, before we hit the road, we're gonna have another star in today's video that you're already familiar with, and that's also the reason why parts of this video are gonna be in German.
Hallo Felix.
Hallo. Wie geht's dir?
Sehr gut, danke. Und selber?
Sehr, sehr gut. Wir müssen leider hier so ein bisschen Abstand wahren. Es sind immer noch spezielle Zeiten, in denen wir hier arbeiten. Ja. Was hast du denn für uns heute vorbereitet?
Ja, es geht um die AMG G-Klasse und ich habe da so ein paar alte Dokumente, alte Bilder in meinem Archiv vorbereitet, so als Einführung für diesen Tag heute.
Klingt super. Dann schauen wir uns das mal an, würde ich sagen, oder?
Gehen wir.
Wunderbar. Okay, ich sehe direkt schon ein paar Highlights, nicht schlecht.
Also ich habe, wie ich dir vorher versprochen habe, ein paar Sachen vorbereitet aus den Anfängen der AMG-Geländewagenproduktion 79, 80. Da haben wir angefangen, für Kunden Geländewagen umzubauen, vor allem Interieur. Und wie du hier siehst, ich habe da mal so ein Beispielbild. Ja.
Ich wollte gerade sagen, ziemlich exotisch. Also da muss man auch schon zweimal hinschauen.
Ja, es war ein ganz spezieller Kundenwunsch. Die Front von seinem G wollte er eine S-Klasse Front. Ja. Das Design ist wirklich von der W116 S-Klasse.
Ja, ich wollte es gerade sagen.
Du siehst es hier am Kühlergrill, der ist sogar 24 Grad vergoldet.
Ja. Tatsächlich?
Das ist tatsächlich so.
Wow, ja. Okay.
Wenn du weiterblätterst, du siehst, was wir sonst noch so vorbereitet haben. Das Fahrzeug war ein Nutzfahrzeug eigentlich, kam aus der Nutzfahrzeugbranche oder Ecke. Beim nächsten Bild, ja, da sehen wir, wir hatten Recaro-Sitze drin, wir hatten komplett Belederung. Das waren so die Anfänge, wo wir die Kunden einfach aus dem Nutzfahrzeug einfach so schon in Richtung Luxusfahrzeug gegangen sind. Ja. Ich habe hier einen, da hatten wir schon etwas mehr drin. Ja. Da gab es Hi-Fi, Video, TV, Klapptische hinten im Fond für die hinten sitzen. Also Sachen, die absolut.
Ja. Okay, das ist ein bisschen älter noch, oder?
Das ist etwas älter, ja. Wow. Da gab es sogar oben über an den Sonnenblenden eine komplette Hi-Fi-Anlage. Ja. Die wurde oben verbaut, überhalb von den Köpfen. Mhm. Ja. Der Fernseh-Videoturm, der kam zwischen die Sitze. Fürs Vorn hinten, ja, also lauter solche absolute speziellen Kundenwünsche.
Nicht schlecht, auch die Sitze wieder. Also man erkennt schon wirklich, es ist noch eine G-Klasse, auch innen von der Form und allem. Hier ist es natürlich sehr rot, viel Leder, also ihr habt ja wirklich überall Hand angelegt, Wahnsinn.
Klar.
Also es waren dann auch Einzelanfertigungen.
Es waren sehr viele Unikate dabei, ja. Am Anfang war es noch diese klassische Leistungssteigerung von den vorhandenen Serienmotoren, ja, die wir dann machten. Also wir hatten eine Entwicklung geplant, das siehst du hier. Mhm. Da hatten wir einfach mal ein V8 eingebaut.
Ah, welcher ist das, der da drin steckt?
Das ist der M117, der Alumotor. Ja. Den gab es dann von uns in verschiedene Hubraumvarianten, also als serienmäßigen 5 Liter bis zu 6 Liter Hubraum. Ja, mit natürlich auch dementsprechend Leistung. Weiter natürlich auch die ganze Technik, also Fahrwerk, Abgasanlage, Sportabgasanlage.
Wahnsinn, das wusste ich gar nicht, dass ihr wirklich schon durch alle Technikkomponenten damals durchgegangen seid in der G-Klasse.
War damals schon der Fall, ja.
Wahnsinn.
Sonderanfertigungen, wo da 7 Sitzer rauskamen. Ja. Wir hatten, weiter hatten wir auch ein XXL gebaut, also eine Verlängerung von der G-Klasse. Lauter solche Komponenten waren dann bei uns im Prinzip schon ganz viele Jahre vorher.
Wahnsinn.
Weltweit natürlich für den Kunden im Angebot.
Ich schiel schon die ganze Zeit so ein bisschen in die Richtung, da schlägt mein Motorsportlerherz natürlich höher, wenn ich solche Bilder sehe. Ihr habt G-Klassen auch für Rallyes vorbereitet?
Hier als Beispiel habe ich die Paris-Dakar, war damals die bekannteste. Hatten wir einen 280 GE vorbereitet mit Leistungssteigerung. Fahrwerk hatten wir verändert und noch einige andere technische Raffinessen.
Klasse, echt der Wahnsinn. Ich lese hier Jockey X. Jockey X ist auch mit einer
Jockey X, für ihn hatten wir auch ein Fahrzeug vorbereitet, ja. Also es gab nichts, was es nicht gab.
Wahnsinn. Also AMG bringt die G-Klasse sogar in den Motorsport. Nicht schlecht, nicht
Richtig.
Schlecht. Ich muss sagen, jedes Mal, wenn ich bei dir hier oben bin, lerne ich wieder was dazu. Es ist echt immer wieder eine helle Freude.
Das freut mich auch.
Danke dir.
Klar, sehr gerne. Ich habe mitbekommen, für dich geht es jetzt weiter. Mhm. Du gehst zur Wiege des G nach Graz. Ich wünsche dir viel Spaß dabei und hau rein.
Dankeschön, Dankeschön. I say that's the sign for us to go outside and hit the road, pack the G63 and go to where the G-Class is actually made. So come on, follow me. Get me home.
Home, starting route guidance.
So we are heading home. Only home in this case means Graz in Austria. That's where we're going today. This is where the G-Class is actually produced. Every G-Class that you see on the road comes out of one factory that is located in Graz in Styria, one of the Austrian states, and that's where we're going today. We're going to the birthplace of the G, if you will. Now you might remember back in our four-wheel drive video, we already had the chance to put the G63 through its paces. That was a lot of fun, together with Mark, and back then he invited us to come to him to Graz to experience the G in its natural habitat firsthand. And I'm gonna pick up right where we left off because I'm gonna meet Mark in Graz and take him up on his offer. Here we are. We made it to Graz. What a drive it was. But it's really time for me to hit the hay, and we meet again tomorrow. All right, after a great night's sleep, it's now time to hit the road again and get to the G-Class Experience Center.
Mr. AMG!
Mr. G!
Warm welcome!
Thank you, thank
How
you.
How was your trip from Stuttgart?
Absolutely amazing, thanks to this.
I think so too.
Thanks for having me.
Warm welcome to the G-Class Experience Center, or how I call it, my living room. So I know you're a real expert for all the AMG models, and especially maybe for the G63.
I'd say so, yeah.
We will test it today, but what we will also do is to have a little bit more off-road experience. Our last time when we met us was in Immendingen, so that was easy off-road. Today we are here at the base of the G-Class in Graz and have a look at the G-Class Experience Center, and especially for the G-Roc. You will discover this with the G-Class together.
That's going to be our playground for today.
One of our playgrounds. We have four prepared for you. So today we will explore the G-Class and we will see both faces. So the shiny one, like your G-Class, but also we will get the muddy one, you know.
Oh, sounds promising.
We have prepared four special tracks. We have two off-road areas and of course two on-road areas. But first of all, I would like to invite you in our G base, because there's really something special. You know maybe about the Amber Cube, you heard about this one?
Oh yeah, I did.
Okay. Let's go inside.
Definitely, yeah.
Okay.
Can't wait.
Have a look.
Wow. I don't even know where to look first in here, but that is really something special.
And really heavy, 44.2 tons, and one of the first G-Class from the model year 79.
Wow.
That was the year when we launched the G-Class.
Absolutely amazing, definitely G-worthy, that thing.
And on the other side, you will see G-Class number one from the world press event from Detroit in the year 2018.
So this is the very first one of the current generation.
Correct. Number nice. One and model year number one from the G63 AMG is still at the plant because mm-hmm. we launched it in Geneva at the motor show.
Yeah. I mean, this also got a V8 under the hood, so that's the important thing to me.
Okay, this is perfect. You're a petrol head. Perfect.
Exactly.
So, here you will see everything. So for every G-Class customer, it's necessary to come one time to Graz, and now we have over 1 million combinations. Now we have 37 colors for the G-Class.
There's something for every taste.
Yes. So every customer is really special, and you see the different color and the stitching of the seats. And every G-Class, it's handmade. Over 80% of the whole car, it's still handmade from our colleagues from Magna. And here you see the game manufacturer in every color.
Wow. Well, there's really nothing that's not possible. I mean, there's colors I've never seen before.
So now they can choose G350 diesel, G400, G500, G63, but now over 1 million combinations. So you can make your own G-Class. Here you can feel the leather, really special, really high quality, the luxury that the customer can also feel.
Nice.
The quality of the seats.
Feels awesome and looks awesome.
So, Felix, I want to show you.
Ah, I recognize that one. That's Jackie X's car up there.
Yes.
We saw that yesterday at the archive.
Really? The original one?
Yeah, well, a picture of it.
A picture, okay. But today we will drive much more slower, okay? So, Felix, here, a really special model. You're missing the chassis.
Awesome.
But on this model, you can see both sides and both faces of the G-Class.
Pretty much.
So, the dirty and muddy version. And on the other side, the shiny version. So my favorite side is the muddy and dirty version.
I kind of tend more towards the on-road side.
I think it depends on your three letters, AMG, maybe. Yeah. So, because you are always perfect dressed with a G-Class. So you can park in the countryside and the mountain everywhere or directly in front of the opera. But I have a special guest for you here, my colleague Florian, and he will give you all the technical details about the new G-Class, and there he is.
Ah, hi, how's it going?
Yeah, I'm fine, and you?
Very well. And I've never seen it undressed like this before. Yeah. This looks pretty interesting, I gotta say.
Yeah, but what you see here is the backbone of the G-Class, more or less. Uh-huh. So you see the leather frame, which is a part we use since 1979. Mm-hmm. The leather frame gives the car the torsion stiffness it needs, and the robustness in his off-road capability.
I already see some pretty serious stuff, I gotta say. I mean, this right here, that looks like proper off-road gear.
The strut brace, it's taking the forces coming from the struts. That gives also much more torsion stiffness to this backbone, more or less. As you can see here, the whole front axle is completely redesigned since our model year 2018. So we have now an independent axle on the front with a double wishbone geometry.
That's actually quite revolutionary for the G-Class. Yeah,
it is. Yes. Yeah, it was a big decision to go in that way, but it was necessary for some things. The first thing was to implement a new steering. Mm. So we have now an electromechanical steering, which gives a way better steering feeling and steering behavior. So that was a thing that was really old fashioned in the old version of the car. And the second thing is that you have to fulfill all the
different regulations.
The threshold
relations.
That front.
Yeah. The threshold
relations.
Yeah. Having had the opportunity to drive the old G63 and the new G63 back to back, I gotta say the steering really makes a world of difference. Yeah. It's so amazing how well that behemoth of a car handles now. It's just mind blowing.
Yeah. So the whole on-road behavior did not one step, but three steps from the old to the new. But we could manage to also add something on the off-road behavior. I won't say we stayed on what we had, but we did one step ahead. When we started with designing the model year 2018, somewhere in 2040, the main aim was we have to build up an off-roader which has on-road abilities and not opposite.
Yeah, makes sense. And you can see that it really came together. Yeah. You recognize the parts from different cars. I mean, I can remember the strut bar, seeing it last on the CLA 45S.
Yes.
Looks completely different, of course. Totally different purpose here on that front. And it is really serious business looking at all those massive parts. Also, the way that the ladder frame sort of wraps around the drive shaft. Really amazing construction you guys got there. But on the rear, you still got a
rigid axle on the rear, as it was before the change. But now with two wishbones. So here you can see the anti-roll bar, which is cutted on the AMG side.
Oh yeah.
So on the rear axle, you have anti-roll bar only on the AMG version.
Oh,
on the
okay.
front axle, the anti-roll bar is also much stiffer than in the normal Daimler version. So you can see the AMG is more for the street, more for on-road, but the DNA is the same in both versions.
So you got a little more flexibility on this side and a little more on-road stiffness on that side.
On that side, yes.
But still maintaining the DNA, of course.
Yes. That's right. One of the special things what is in the DNA of every G-Class are the differential locks. Mm. You have three different differential locks on the G-Class, so on the front and rear axle and in between on the gearbox.
The center part.
So, gentlemen, I think you talked a lot about the theory. Our fans from the firm AMG Format want to see the real conditions in the G-Class, and I want to show you the piano, how we call it, the three magic buttons in reality.
Nice.
So, gentlemen, please follow me.
Let's go.
All G-Class customers who want to go with their G63 to go off-road, we have a special package and version. That's the G63 with trail package.
Nice.
You see on the tires, that's a 20-inch all-terrain tire. But
also nice rims, like
perfect.
It.
Perfect. But this is really special.
Yeah.
We had a new one, that's called the shackle-proof badge.
Mm-hmm.
And the shackle, that's the place where the G-Class learned to walk. And Felix, I want to show you, going straight up like 45 kilometers in this direction, you see the small mountain, that's the shackle.
That's it back there.
That's the shackle.
The
and that's
world
the place,
famous shackle.
And that's the place where the G-Class learned to walk. And the test track is like 5.6 kilometers, but we measure only 3.4, and every G-Class must go up and down to get at 2,000 kilometers. That means 330 times up and 330 times down. And this is perfect because it's all rocky, because we never change the surface, and we have all the data since the last 40 years. So when we improve, and our aim is to improve always the G-Class to make it better and better, because when we launched the G-Class, the aim was to build the best off-road vehicle in the world. That's what we did, what we do, and what we always will do in the future. And that's the place where we always test and measure.
The place of inception. Nice.
That's
cool.
Really heavy for the chassis, for the whole car, but the maximum slope on the shackle mount, it's only 50%. Today you will go until 80, until 100.
100% incline.
That means 45 degree. 45 degree you can do with every car. But sometimes with many cars, only one time.
Yeah.
With the G-Class, you can do it much more often. But before we will start, I want to show you the piano, the three diff locks.
Okay.
How does it work? So we have here prepared four rolls. These rolls are open, so it's like slippery, like snow and ice. We lock these two, so we will have traction on this roll. These rolls are open too. And these rolls are fixed. So, on this two, we will have traction. On the other two, we have no traction. Jump around, so Florian is in the car. So when we go off-road, we all start with the low gear, with the reduction, and we always lock the center lock. Then we have no ABS, no ESP, no electronic help system. That's a real car now. So, Florian, please come inside. And when we lock in a normal G-Class, we go back to 50% of the power on the front axle and 50 on the rear. So normally we have 40 and 60 with
60.
The new generation. But if you lock the center, you go back to 50-50. Florian, please.
What happens now?
What's happened now? So we have two spinning wheels. One spinning wheel on the rear, and at the same time, one spinning wheel at the front. Now you can give full acceleration, but nothing happens. When you're driving in the dunes, you only go down, not forward.
Dig yourself in.
So that's the reason why we can lock number two, the rear diff lock. That means we will get a stiff connection from both wheels, from one axle. and one wheel will bring us forward and you will hear. So Florian, please, because on this tire we have traction but no power at the moment. Mm-hmm. When Florian press number two, you will hear it and the G-class will move forward.
Ah, crazy.
And the reason why we have three diff locks in the car, I will show you now. Flo, please come reverse and stop. And now go back to drive, please. So now we have three spinning wheels.
That is so crazy.
We are only on one wheel in the front. We have normally traction. But when we look on the other side, you see, Felix, that the front wheel, it's much faster than on the rear. It's totally easy. So we lock the center. That means 50% of the power will be on the front axle.
But all goes to one wheel.
And 50 on the rear, and that means 25 each. Yeah. And the reason why we have three diff locks is to lock now number three. That means all four wheels have the same rotation all the time. And trust me, for the cheetahs, it's only one way, only forward. So Florian, please press number three, and you will see it's locked, the clutch is in, and the cheetahs will move.
Like magic.
That's it.
The three magic buttons. Well, now I got it. Now I definitely got it.
We will see the whole day if you got it. So now I want to show you the axle twist. And you learned that we have now a single suspension in the front. On the rear you can see a rigid axle. Long damping ways. But we never lose anything on our off-road capability. So, second diff lock and the car will tip.
Holy cow.
That's perfect. That's the way how to change a tire in the desert. And then he comes up and down, and you see, have a look at the rigid axle, long damping way. And then, so, and if you're really strong.
Let me catch it in case it falls
it's
over.
It's so easy to tip a G-class, huh? So. And please, on this wall, you
oh
will
my
see
God.
The off-road capabilities of a G-class, and this six key figures means for us to be the best off-road vehicle in the world. And when we launch a new one, we make a much better on-road performance, but we never do any compromise on the off-road performance.
I can see that. I mean, this almost looks comical. You look at it and you go like, there's no way any car in the world could ever drive over that.
Later you will get the same, but on natural ground. And here you can see ground clearance. Around about 24 centimeters. The maximum inclination is 35 degrees. The previous model it was only 29. Now we have maximum fording depth until 70 centimeters. Maximum slope 100%, 45. It's similar as to the previous model.
100%.
And trust me, in the afternoon you will get the feeling what means 100%. It's not only a number and it's not 45 degrees outside temperature. It feels
my stomach's already turning just thinking about it.
Perfect. And angle of departure, angle of approach are similar or a little bit better as in the previous model. So we never make any compromises because cheese means off-road, and it is, and it was, and it will be in the future the best off-road vehicle in the world. So, and then I want to show you the side inclination. So Florian, please. And Felix, I always get the question, what is the real chipping point for a G-class?
I can't even look at it.
You can go until 35 degrees. Maybe
holy
a little bit
moly
more. And then you can play, you can do everything. But you see, so the real tipping point, it depends on the pressure of the tires, if you have something on the roof, and how fast you will go in the obstacle. This mixed together, and there's no warning system. The game is totally easy. When it was too much, the car will tip.
Yeah.
But mostly for our customer, your brain said, oh, that's the limit. But today you will go until 35 degrees. Florian, thank you so much for your support and your technical information.
You're welcome. And Felix, enjoy your day here on the G-Class Experience in Graz.
I Flo, I will do my best. So Felix, now we are ready for Rumble. Come
thanks,
on.
Thanks for having us.
So Felix, I think we will start with your favorite car, with the AMG.
Yes.
So you will get today individual coaching from my side. So please jump inside.
Don't have to tell me twice.
Yes.
Been waiting for this all day.
And Felix, you know, S-Class with the soft close.
Yeah.
You know the soft close version from Graz?
No.
That will be our sound. This is our soft close. So please start the engine. You know which program. So we will start with a handling parkour. We will do a little bit of slalom, full acceleration, you know, 585 horsepower. From 0 to 100, 4.5 seconds. So Felix, please keep going.
Awesome.
You must go back to drive before you start. So Felix, we will start slalom on Sports Plus. The track is free for you. Go, my friend. 16, try all the time the same speed. Right, left, much easily. No braking, it's an AMG, my friend, what you're doing? It's not a GTR Black Series what we launched yet.
That wasn't me, that
it's
was
a
ESP.
G-class. Much more smoothly, more comfort. So try again. The slalom open, much more closer to the coins, easily. Oh, that was the first one. It's not a bowling track here. What you are doing, my friend? The last one. Be gentle with the car. Go for it. It's a G63. Yes. Right and left. Closer. Right. Yes. Go forward. Yes. That looks pretty. Oh, one hit. Two hittings. Oh, no. So, Felix, now I want to show you and I want that you will feel it, the acceleration of the G63. That means 4.5 seconds. Full acceleration and at my line, you will do a full braking. Okay, 3, 2, 1, and go. Go, 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 go. And now full brake. Perfect, well done. 130, 140.
Best day at work ever. All right, what's up next?
Lane exchange with wet surface. We start the first thing without braking with 50 kilometers per hour. You will start to steer after the two yellow cones. So please go with 50. And it's not a bowling ground, okay? 50, it's
yeah,
totally
yeah,
easy.
I
please
understood.
Go.
I understood you.
And all we drive all in Sports Plus mode. Right, yes, perfect, well done.
Oh, that didn't feel too bad. It's still amazing how nimble this car feels considering how tall and heavy it is.
We do the same with 70 kilometers. The track is free, it's for you, go. Smooth steering, go. Looks nice. And left and right, it goes straight, perfect.
So that was 70 and it felt like the car didn't even try. Amazing.
So Felix, we will do the same now with 85 because you're a professional driver. You can do the same with 85, no braking. Please go. And the G-Class, it's really safe and comfortable. Yes, perfect. And now turn left and right, yes. Okay, well done.
Didn't feel too bad. Did I hit a cone? Ah, oh, I got one. Well, Mark promised a playground when he invited us, and he definitely kept his word.
So Felix, we had the second off-road challenge and obstacle, the skid plate. Go for your first round. When you lose the control by a vehicle, always press the brake and then you will be safe and smooth and easily. But please, it's your turn. 45 kilometers per hour. Go back, perfect, and turn left, back. Well done, well done.
Ah,
what's the difference between 45 and 52? 7 kilometers. My friend, you're always too fast. I think that's a problem of the AMG colleagues.
All right, this time 45.
45, counter steering, soft and smooth with the steering wheel. Go turn right and now for brake. Yeah, not too bad for the second run. It's not similar like a GT.
No, it isn't.
And then we go back to the start, completely ESP off, and you will do the same with 40 kilometers. and then I'm sure you will feel the difference. So the track is free, be careful. And sometimes you will have a dancing G-Class. We call it the Wiener Walzer, the famous dance from Austria. So please.
All right, Wiener Walzer it is. 40 kilometers.
It's much
weird,
more difficult as with the ESP on, and you will see what's happening.
Holy.
Totally on the brake. Yeah, that's totally normal. That's a free clean wash also. Perfect. Well done. And we do it twice in the second round.
There was literally nothing I could do to stop that car from spinning.
Everyone can it. So go for the next one. So we will do it now with 40 ESP off. Go for it.
Let's dance.
Always on the brake. Wonderful.
Okay.
That's it. So here you can see, oh, that's neutral because for the car was a safety feature. Now go back to drive. It's not so easy. So we are really happy that we have all this electronic like ABS and ESP.
Oh. Wow, we only did 3 on-road exercises and I'm already a sweating mess. So there's definitely a lot more to look forward to in part 2 of our epic G-Class journey. So stay tuned for that. See you guys in the next one.